Hey everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today it's mid-July, it's humid again, and today we're doing vegetables and toadstools. Not the kind of toadstools that are related to the mushrooms, but they will be kind of like practical garden art. Right now I want to show you our cucumbers. Our cucumbers were the first to produce any thing this year. We've had one already, and look at this bee right here. This, I believe, is a burpless. And I was told that you should cut them with just leave a little bit of the stem on where you cut it off. And for whatever reason, that's supposed to be more healthy than just pulling it off or twisting it off. I see several more. There's another one there. There's two more there. There's a couple over here. But this is the only one that's actually ready.
Yeah, there's another one right in here. Yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Look how long it is, too.
Yep.
That's a biggie.
Yep.
You're going to let it get...
Yes, fatter.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then, oops, get back up there. I put you up there for a reason.
I want to thank Bitterbilt for those...
Yes.
Trellises. Well, really helps.
I don't want to stay there. Now we also, just from standing right here, I can see that we have spaghetti squash there.
Yeah. I see another one on the other side too.
Another one on the other side, yes.
Yeah.
And then, right there, if you'll notice,
we
have a yellow zucchini.
Oh, that one's ready for picking.
Yes, and then there's another one on the ground.
Oh yes, there it is. Very cool.
Now with these, I cut them at the stem. I cut, well usually I just twist them if I can. Last week, I again put fresh dill around the roots. So far, so good with the squash borers. Here the other day, when I cut this, see? Just amazing. This is the perfect size, actually.
Well, it looks like your garlic's going to be ready probably within another week, two at the most.
And I need to get out here and reposition these vines before they take over. Here's an eggplant. Now, these are the skinny long ones. That's the kind I like. And this fascinates me. The way it just emerges out of that.
Blossom.
Mm-hmm. And there's another one over here. Pretty. Something else that is also doing very nicely is the kale. This is the dinosaur kale, and you can see why they call it dinosaur kale, because it looks like you would expect dinosaur skin to look like. So when I'm picking that, I look for the ones that haven't been chewed on by animals or insects. I figure I'll leave those for them, and then I will pick the ones I want. This kale in particular is even more sweet once the first frost comes. It's that tough. Now this is dinosaur. This is red Russian kale. And these under here were my first beans that I planted, and they are finally blossoming.
Oh, you've had four different plantings already.
I have, because none of my beans seem to be working. So that was number one. Over there was number two.
Under the squash, way over there.
Under the squash, right. Then I didn't think those were working, so I planted these. These, thank goodness, are not blossoming yet. And the fourth one will be over in the Liberty Garden. After I'm done painting, I'm going to sneak over here and eat some of our original raspberries. This is where we got all of our other raspberries, and I chop on these every now and again, but knowing that we weren't going to have a whole lot over there, I kind of let these grow this year, so we do have a few raspberries.
Uh-huh. Now you see why they never make it in the house. Mm-hmm. Great.
Years ago, Rick made some little stools to sit on in the garden. And over the years, they have deteriorated because they've been out in the weather and they were never really painted or stained or preserved at all except for the green wood that he used. So today is the day that he's working on the garden toadstools. This is what it looks like. He has posts in the ground. Those are 4x4s, right?
Yep.
In the ground, and then he made this. There's a name to that pattern. Like they have in the art museums.
Well, I'm thinking of fabric and bricklaying too.
Yes.
We'll
think of it.
Yeah.
Anyway, so he pre-cut all of these pieces, and then when he came out to do them, he realized that he was going to have to recut them all to fit each particular post. Post seems to be different, and then every piece that fits into the puzzle is different.
Well, a 4x4 is not 4x4, obviously, not even 3.5x3.5. And the same with a 6x6. I mean, that should be a 5.5x5.5, but some are 5.5, some are 5.25. So now that I pre-cut everything, I've got to redo a lot of it.
We just brought the saw outside so he didn't have to keep running into the garage and then back outside again. So he has this one finished. He's got the one over there finished.
Now that's a 6x6.
That's the 6x6 one. That's a big one. He has this one finished, and as you can see, we're painting the tops of them to match the archway, which I just repainted again. I've wanted to do it all summer. This was the first chance we have. Again, it's hot and it is so humid, it feels like Florida. Now, I'm sorry if you live in Florida, but we're not used to this. We have thick blood, I think, no matter how long these days last. It keeps looking like it's going to rain, but so far it hasn't, thank goodness.
I think I've already drank a couple of gallons of water. And
you have? Well, I can see.
Sweat is just dripping. Yeah, sweat is just dripping off of me everywhere. I don't think I have a dry piece of clothing on anymore.
Did you want to see the one that you haven't done yet?
Yes.
Okay, let's go look at that one. As you can see, these are all the pre-cut pieces. 3 different sizes. He's measured them, he's added extra to make them fit, and still each one is different. So
well, you know, they always say measure twice, cut once. I've measured 3 times and cut once, and they're still not matching, which is very frustrating.
So each one is an individual, unique stool. So this is what the old ones look like. And this one is actually in fairly good shape, considering. It's probably because it's very sheltered. It's not in the direct sunlight. So he'll rip that off. Well, you're going to leave that one, right?
Well, for now I'm going to leave it, and this is one I'm going to work on next. So.
Right, and this is another 6x6.
It's
5.5x5.25, whatever it is.
And it's starting to drizzle again. We cannot get out of this rain every day or every other day pattern. This is ridiculous.
Do we need to move this on to the porch?
Yes, we're going to have to move everything. So let's stop this for right now.
Okay. I get the fun part.
Well, somebody has to have the fun. Might as well be you.
I'll let you sit on them.
Oh, thank you. Right now?
No.
Well, we remembered what it was called. It's called herringbone pattern.
There, that's it, that's it.
And if you look at this, now that the rain has stopped, I'm continuing. You know, basically you're starting with the width of whatever post you're doing, and you're allowing a little extra for the width of the 2x4 that you're going to be adding. And basically you keep kind of working around, kind of like a merry-go-round. And the next one, again, is going to be cut a 2x4 longer, again, that width, extra width. And I like to put screws at both ends so that this screw is going to go into this one, and this screw over here will be into the center, and this one is going to be added in here for support. Now later on I'll add more than just one screw. I may even add a fourth screw in here if I feel it needs that extra security. So what I do is I put it in place, get myself a clamp.
He used to use me.
Oh, I still do. But I try to get this in as nice a position as possible. Again, that works out really well. It's nice to have an extra set of hands. And I actually like to put the center one in first. And then I'll just continue to wrap around and around and around and around and do the next layer. And I'll get three layers on there, and that's when I'll stop. Well, with the last one, this is one that I also like to cut at a 45 degree angle so that people don't bump their knees into a corner, sharp corner.
That's nice.
So you can see how this herringbone pattern works. Basically, this will butt right up against there.
Very nice.
So again,
so it's just like rounding off the corners.
Right, exactly.
Excellent. Well, this will be the last piece to go on this toadstool. And now you can see the patterns, and you can also see the corners, the rounded corners, and it's very, very sturdy. I have stepped on these. I have put things on these. Wait a minute. Richard, you're not supposed to do that on the furniture.
Well, somebody has to have fun. I'll sand this down. And you're going to paint?
Yes, I am.
Different, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. It looks brand new. Now that Rick is done with all the power tools, I get to use my little elbow grease and actually just do some fine sanding on the edges. Make sure there's no slivers. And then I'll fill this with a little bit of caulk. This is the old stump. And then prime them and paint them. So we have three toadstools over there plus the archway, and then these two. So that's a total of five toadstools. Good job, Richard. We've had some time to cool down, and one of us got to shower. And now we came out to see just how it looks now that we have done the work. So there's this, the arch behind me with the flamingos back on. Then there's one toadstool to the right of that, and then two in front of the screen porch. And then there's these two behind me that are waiting to dry. Well, they're drying now, and they're waiting for me to sit on them and rest myself. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. It supports our Wisconsin Garden vlog, and we would love to hear from you if you have comments or questions. And as always, if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe.
So now you've got your red color that peeks
the peaks.
The west garden area.
Yes, a few little splashes here and there.
Yeah, that's very inviting.
Yes, it is. And they're going to be smooth and cozy.
Yep.
And not
no splinters.
Slivery.
Connect with us on YouTube.